spare paddles, paddle leashes, and paddle breeches. So questions on these three come up often, so I thought it'd be great to just tackle them all at once. I often hear the question, do I really need to bring an extra paddle? And the answer is not automatically yes, but I do think that having a spare paddle within the group that is paddling is a good idea. And what I mean is, with different groups that I paddled in, or expeditions, or just day outings, or just fun surf sessions, we have paddles that have broken. And it's always useful to have at least one spare in the group so that whoever has that misfortune of a paddle breaking can easily paddle home without any problems. Another thing that has happened to me is someone goes over, you go to do a rescue, let's say with a group or if you're guiding, or if you have to get to someone very quickly and you don't have time to perfectly put your paddle away on your bungees, you can't just throw it between the two kayaks, and the two kayaks being together will usually keep that paddle between the two kayaks. But if I need to help someone that's in need, I don't want to be thinking about, oh, if I lose my paddle, how do I then get around? I know that I have my spare paddle. At any point, I can go focus on the person. Even if I lose my paddle, no big deal. I could either recover it later, someone else in the group can get it, and I just feel confident having that second paddle. Is it absolutely necessary? In most cases, you probably will not lose your paddle. You probably will not break a paddle. But let's say you're paddling many miles in a day, even if it's perfect weather, if something does happen to that paddle, just having that spare one will get you home easily. Now let's get to the other area of why I think it's not really more about a spare paddle, but the opportunity to have a change of paddle. And that's really the way I see it all the time. Let's say I'm going on the water with a Greenland paddle in hand. I love the idea of having another option as my spare. So it's not if something happens to this one, I can replace it. It's more of if I happen to maybe, let's say we find some waves and I want to get on and I want more power at my disposal, I can easily grab a different blade and it's accessible to me. It also serves the idea of having that safety and extra paddle, but it's more about just having an option. The same thing might be where if I'm going out with a big blade in hand, I'll just have a Greenland that breaks into two pieces. That way I can have that on my back deck as my option. So I love having both styles of paddles at my disposal at any point. And if someone in the group needs a spare paddle, I have one to offer. Now, one more thing to mention, if you didn't want to have it on your deck, because having less things on your deck is usually a good thing so that the wind doesn't affect it and you don't have, or if you're doing a rescue or a cowboy, having nothing on the back deck makes things a little easier. If that's the case for you, they do make four pieces. This one, for example, breaks down at the blade as well. I could pull this out and then I would be able to put all four pieces in one of the bulkheads. I can carry a spare paddle without it ever being anywhere on the deck. Personally, I like having it on the deck so I have easy access to it, but there are lots of options depending on what you want to do. Now let's talk about leashes. Leashes is an interesting topic because if you browse forums online, you will have people that absolutely love them on one side and absolutely hate them and think it's a death trap on the other. I know paddlers, and I'm friends with paddlers, that some of them, they swear on their leashes, and also they feel that as long as they have a knife on them with easy access, if anything were to happen, they're able to cut that leash. On the other hand, I also have paddlers that have told me very bluntly that they don't think paddle leashes are a good idea. I have seen both sides. I'll just tell you the stories that have made me decide to not use one. But I can see the positives and negatives on both sides. So I'll just give you what made me make the decision, but I think it's just up to you whether you want to use one or not. A wave knocked me over. I was kind of window shading a bit. So one of the things you want to try to do usually when you're capsized is hold on to that paddle. I remember one of the blades, I felt it get stuck in the sand. And the wave was trying to push me because I was still in the kayak upside down. The wave was pushing me down towards the beach and it was putting a lot of strain on me. And I just remember feeling, I'm so glad that I don't have a leash. If I need to, I can just let go right now and it's not that big a deal. And most people I know won't use paddle leashes in surf. But just for me, when I felt that amount of power tugging at me from both the paddle on one side and the kayak on the other, I was thinking, let's say I'm out on a beautiful calm day all day, and then I need to land in a little bit of surf, and I forget to put away the leash, then this could be a possible scenario that could arise. So for me, I just thought, okay, this is a learning experience. And then another thing that did happen to me was whenever I take my big casing for my camera, I always tether it to something. And there's been, and I like to try to either take pictures or film people in surf. I have been knocked over in surf or fallen over, and I have gone over and gotten that leash to be a nuisance when I'm trying to either roll back up or, and it's pulling on me, and the camera is just bulky and annoying. So the lessons I learned there was make that tether shorter, and I always tether it to myself so that if at any point I need to jump out of the kayak, I'm not gonna get wrapped up in something and the kayak is gonna drag me down. The camera is with me. But overall, because of those situations, I do not like using leashes. I'd rather just know that I can let go of the paddle if I need to at any point, and then I have my spare. And I think whatever works for you is fantastic. So the last one, paddle breeches. Paddle breeches are these holders here that you can attach to your rigging, your deck rigging, so that they can help you hold your spare paddles. One of the benefits is that it's easy to get them in and out without scratching your kayak. And if waves or water splash around, usually these are also helpful at keeping the paddles in place and not moving. So the reason I bring it up is oftentimes in videos, I'll get the question of why I keep them in my back deck. Most people like keeping them on the front deck. One of the reasons for that is so that if you do have to do a cowboy rescue, you have a clear back deck and it's easy to make your way up without the paddles being in the way. For me, I feel confident that if I take a swim, if I fall out of the boat, I feel confident in my re-enter and roll, or doing a cowboy where I'm not making my way all the way from the back of the boat. I'll just come kind of across the cockpit, get in, and then sit. Another reason I like them in the back is that I find whenever we go surfing that punching through waves is usually where there's the most power hitting the front deck, and anything that's in the front will get knocked around a lot easier. The breeches help, but very often whenever a wave would hit the front of the kayak, it would knock things around. So having them in the back makes things a little easier. But the main reason I really like them in the back, if you're using breeches, the breeches usually sit all the way near the end of the kayak. So whenever you have your spare paddle in the front, I find that if I'm sitting in the kayak and the paddle breeches are keeping the paddles over there, I can't, from the sitting position, get to the paddle. The tip might be over here, and it's very hard for me to get all the way there quickly. Where if they're in the back, I have very easy access to them. So one of the things, especially during pool sessions, that I used to like to practice was capsize, lose a paddle, reach back, grab one half of the paddles and try to roll up, or grab both pieces, try to put it together, roll up. It's a really fun exercise, but what I really like is just how easy, or let's say I'm assisting someone or I lose my paddle, I need to get to someone quickly. I have very easy access to them sitting right here versus trying to deal getting to the front or having to ask someone to come help me. But that's just personal preference. It's what's worked for me. Maybe it'll spark ideas for you to try different things and see what works best for you. But for example, if you rely on a cowboy rescue where you are making your way all the way from the back of the kayak, this might not be the best idea for you. It might be better to just have them in the front. And don't get me wrong, a lot of people like having the spare paddle here where the actual blades are easily reached over here. But I like having the deck for many other things. For example, a chart or camera gear, or I like having this area clear when I used to have my paddles here, it would then take away from being able to put other stuff. It ended up being that I had to add stuff on top of the paddles, and then I could tell whenever it got windy that it made a difference. Where in the back, it feels more streamlined, and for me, it just works a little better. So those are answers to those three questions. I hope they were helpful. If there's any comments on how you feel about one way or another, spare paddles, having a leash, or where you like to put your spare paddle on the kayak, please comment below. We would love to hear what you have to say. And if there's any further questions, do comment as well. So I hope that was helpful. Subscribe if you like. I'm always trying to put these videos out. And as always, Luke Romer, Cat Gipster. Thanks for watching. See you next.